For joining us here this morning. I do appreciate your extra patience as this is a milestone event, 50 years, and it was important for us to get as many people here that were still showing up in here as possible on time, so thank you so much. My name is John Ledoux, and on behalf of the Dayton VA Medical Center, the Miami Valley Military History Museum, and the United States of America, I want to thank you for coming today to join us in honoring our Vietnam veterans and their families. Now, if you are able, please rise and remain standing for the invocation by Chaplain Victor Tony and the national anthem sung by Robert Martin.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hail at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the
I invite you to join me as I pray. Almighty and gracious God, we thank you for our Vietnam veterans, true patriots all, who serve faithfully sacrifice willingly, without complaint, often in anonymity, to ensure the most precious gift we have. We call it freedom. For these men and women who faithfully answered the call of their country and returned to a nation who did not understand their motivation nor appreciate the personal cost of their service, today we remember, we honor, and with humble gratitude we say thank you for putting on the uniform and going where so few have gone. And we say a belated welcome home. As we meet to honor our Vietnam veterans, we also remember those who did not return and the loved ones back home whose reunion never came. Their sacrifice shall never be forgotten. May we always pray for and support those who for the rest of their lives grieve the loss of their husband, father, son, daughter, or friend in the service of our country. May they always know and feel the humble gratitude of a grateful and free nation. God bless us and bless these United States of America. In your holy and loving name we pray. Amen.
Please be seated. Please join me in thanking Chaplain Tony and Mr. Martin, both veterans themselves, as well as the Deccan Knights Honor Guard from the Dayton Early College Academy. Since the birth of the United States, no single generation of Americans has been spared the responsibility of defending freedom by force of arms. More than 44 million American men and women have sacrificed and served in time of war. Many here counted among them. Your collective service and individual sacrifices have safeguarded the cherished concepts embodied in our Constitution. Every generation of veterans has shared in the service, shared in the brotherhood, and shared in the sacrifices so uniquely associated with wearing the uniform. But one generation was asked to shoulder more than their fair share of the burden, without ever receiving their fair share of the gratitude of our nation. I am referring, of course, to our Vietnam veterans. On Memorial Day 2012, the President spoke at the Vietnam Veterans Memorial, the Wall, during an event which was attended by the most senior military and civilian leaders, and more importantly, thousands of Vietnam veterans and their families, the true VIPs. The President's words were powerful. He stated, and I quote, "And one of the most painful chapters in our history was Vietnam, most particularly how we treated our troops who served there. You were often blamed for a war you didn't start. When you should have been commended for serving your country with valor, you were sometimes blamed with misdeeds of a few. When the honorable service of the many should have been praised, you came home and sometimes were denigrated. When you should have been celebrated, it was a national shame, a disgrace that should have never happened. And that's why here today we resolve that it will not happen again." And in that same sentiment, we gather today for the Vietnam 50th War Commemoration and Pinning Ceremony. I know we have Vietnam veterans and their families in this audience. I ask that every Vietnam veteran among us please stand if you are able, so we might recognize your service and sacrifice and finally begin the welcome home you all rightly deserve. Ladies and gentlemen, your Vietnam veterans. Thank you, you may be seated. Now we will have welcome remarks by the Dayton VA Medical Center Chief of Staff, Dr. Tom Hardy. Dr. Hardy is an Army veteran and began his service as an infantry platoon leader in the famed 101st Airborne Division. He also served as an Army Ranger and served for 18 months in Vietnam as an advisor to the Vietnamese Infantry Unit prior to attending medical school. He is a graduate of the Army War College and holds a master's degree in administrative medicine from the University of Wisconsin. I am pleased to present you, Dr. Hardy. Sir?
Well, good morning. I went to college to be a Lutheran minister. I like the way this feels up here. We welcome all to the Vietnam 50th commemoration and pinning ceremony. I'd like to begin this morning by acknowledging some of our distinguished guests. First of all, I'd like to acknowledge General Meckenbauer, who's been sitting by me in the front row. General, it is indeed an honor to share that space with you. I'd also like to recognize the president of the Vietnam Veterans Memorial Park, Mark Kucharski. Mark and I have known each other for quite some time. Eugene Sanders is here today, representing Congressman Mike Turner. Doug Ledbetter is here from our National Cemetery. He's the director of Dayton's National Cemetery. Bob Stone is here, the mayor of Beaver Creek. And Scotty Sly is here, a Trotwood City Councilman. We also have the president of the Beaver Creek Chamber of Commerce, Ann Up the Grove Vore. And Byron Stewart is here on behalf of our city commissioner, Matt Joseph. If there's a fire, we have the Dayton Fire Chief here, Jeffrey Payne, so welcome. Tim Betty is here from the St. Mary's Development Corporation. Steve Goman, who's the president of the Miami Valley Military Affairs Association. And the association has been very helpful in helping us prepare for this event. Along with the Miami Valley Military History Museum staff. In the back, we have a proclamation from Ohio Senator Keith Faber, who could not be here but sends his regards. We also have here, under the almost too numerous to recognize category, our veteran service organizations, whether they be the American Legion, the VFW, the disabled veterans, and members of the community who have for many years given great support to the Dayton VA Medical Center. I really appreciate all that you have done and continue to do. And last but not least, I thank my fellow Vietnam veterans. Welcome here and to all the veterans who have come here today and attended this service. You know, before I started working here at the Dayton VA 3 years ago, I never thought much about Vietnam. When I came home, I took my Vietnam experience and I put it in a little box and I locked it up and I put it away, frankly. I had a friend some years ago ask me about Vietnam and I said it's almost like a story somebody told me or a book I read. I couldn't get back there. And then I started to work here and I walked out into the lobby and I saw a 1st Cavalry Division patch and a 101st patch and a Big Red 1 patch and a Aviation Brigade patch and a 1st Marine Division patch and Navy and Air Force. And all of a sudden, you know, things came back to me I hadn't thought about in a number of years. I know all of us as Vietnam veterans have our own memories of what Vietnam was like and carry them with us to this day, to this ceremony. My most poignant memory about Vietnam isn't about the time I served over there in combat. It actually occurred after I came back from Vietnam. I was given as an additional duty the job of being the OIC of a burial detail for a soldier who had been killed in Vietnam. That burial detail was in a small central Pennsylvania town up in the mountains. I remember a hillside cemetery. I remember a flag-draped casket by an open grave. I remember a 21-gun salute. I remember that we played taps, and then we folded the flag, which had been on the casket. My job as the officer in charge was to take that folded flag and to turn to the family and present the flag to the family with a 50-word script that I had memorized. On behalf of the President of the United States and the Secretary of Defense, I'd like to present this flag as a token of, and at that moment, the mother of the soldier knocked the flag from my hands, jumped up, and grabbed me by the lapels and said, "Why did my son have to die in that damn war?" I stood back, I picked the flag up and gave it to the father. And when I looked at the mother, I didn't have a good answer for her. 50 years later, I still don't have a good answer. I can only say that I know her son and the over 58,000 men and women who died in Vietnam, the over 1,600 who were still missing in action, the over 600 prisoners of war, of which we have one in our midst today, and all of you who served with me in Vietnam did our duty. And for that reason, I am proud to stand here with you today as we commemorate 50 years since the war in Vietnam. I am hopeful that this small ceremony today will acknowledge the sacrifices that so many people made in Vietnam and will provide us as Vietnam veterans with some measure of closure and some relief for our families and friends who supported us then and continue to support us.
Thank you, Dr. Hardy. Now we are going to be showing you a video called "Thank You for Your Service."
Thank you for your support.
So I hope that all of you were able to hear that video. If not, I strongly encourage you to go out to the Dayton VA Medical Center Facebook page. We posted it this morning. It's very powerful, and it means a lot to me. So I've been deployed to 3 overseas locations myself. And when my tours were done, I was thanked. I was welcomed home with hugs and handshakes. I had meals bought for me. And I cannot fathom what many of you and what most Vietnam veterans experienced when they came home. It was nothing like my experience. And so for that, I'm thankful that we are here today doing this, and I'm thankful to be a part of it. Also, there are service members coming home today from today's battlefields with both physical and unseen injuries of war, much like Vietnam veterans did as well. But sadly, many of the Vietnam veterans had unseen injuries that went undiagnosed, and people weren't exactly sure how to deal with these issues, the medical community, the general public. And as they are now, all too often, Vietnam veterans were left to meet those challenges alone without the assistance available to veterans today. Yet most of the Vietnam veterans, many of you, will tell you that they are the lucky ones, as 58,307 of their brothers and sisters never came home. Their names are forever inscribed on the wall, and we shall never forget. As Dr. Hardy mentioned, there were also prisoners of war, and approximately 1,600 are still missing in action today. Today, our guest speaker is a Vietnam veteran. He is also a former prisoner of war, Major General Edward Meckenbeier. General Meckenbeier graduated from the U.S. Air Force Academy in 1964. He served in Vietnam and flew 79 missions. Then, in June of 1967, General Meckenbeier and his F-4C aircraft were shot down over North Vietnam. He was a prisoner of war for 6 years. General Meckenbeier continued his service when he returned home, including on active duty in the Ohio National Guard and with the Air Force Reserve. He is a command pilot with more than 3,500 flying hours, and he retired from service in June of 2004. General Meckenbeier is the recipient of the Distinguished Service Medal, the Silver Star with Oak Leaf Cluster, the Distinguished Flying Cross with Oak Leaf Cluster, the Bronze Star Medal with V Device, the Purple Heart with Oak Leaf Cluster, and the Air Medal with silver and 3 bronze Oak Leaf Clusters, among others. A full copy of his bio is located in your programs, and at this time it is my sincere honor to welcome Major General Edward Meckenbeier.
Okay, thanks, John. Appreciate that. Dr. Hardy, I'll give you a rosary, and you can be a Catholic priest up here. Well, you know a way to keep old generals from talking too long is to give them notes, so we're going to do that. One thing I got to do, of course, is as a satisfied customer of this place, I got to say thanks to Dr. Hardy again, to all the people here, for keeping the Dayton VA out of the news. You know, we have great service here by great people, and thank you. It's a real privilege for me to come back into this building where I was, 10 or 12 years ago, when you couldn't walk everywhere on the floor because there were holes in it. The paint was literally bubbling off the walls, and to pay tribute to all the wonderful people who made this thing into the beautiful National Historic Site that it is today. I was shot down on my 113th mission. Actually, I had the proud opportunity to fly about 30, 35 missions in country in South Vietnam, supporting the Army before I was shot down on my 80th mission over North Vietnam. And you know, we can all look back and think, the word history conjures up images of dusty events of long ago. And the value of history is usually considered entertainment more than enlightenment. We have textbooks and lecture series to educate and explain what we must know and remember. And the Vietnam War is now more than 4 decades since its conclusion in 1975, so it's just about ready to qualify for that old and barely interesting category for all except those of us who lived it. Of course, our version keeps getting better and more exciting and more interesting as we recreate the events of our lives for our grandchildren and anybody else stupid enough or bold enough to ask. No, individually we're not the stuff of whom epic stories are told, or someone whose contributions made a measurable impact on the course of events or the war in Vietnam. So just who are we that our community is recognizing and honoring now? Today, museums, books, and documentaries are the repositories and the keepers of our story, some of them even old enough to be in black and white. And they collect the artifacts of our trade, some of which are in the back here. We are recognized for that service along with that of the men and women who served in the previous conflicts. We are not unique, really, but today our nation says thank you and recognize all the men and women who served in Vietnam. To the spouses, I say also, this is your day, for you too are a critical part of the team. You too are truly veterans. Now, many have answered duties called to defend in the armed combat the freedoms which we cherish. Many people here today, seated, came home safe and told their stories of survival. Many of our friends did not make it home, and their families and friends have only memories and stories to tell. There are many who came home still live with a physical and mental suffering. This facility does a great job in helping that. They continue to pay the price for their service and our freedom. Today, our military faces a diverse set of national security challenges. These challenges demand a strong, flexible military force that is ready to respond at a moment's notice. And we have that force. We train them and add it to the heritage of each of our uniformed services. Today, 30 March 2016, is the 9,150th day of continuous combat for this nation. This war has gone on more than 21 years longer than the war to end all wars. World War II lasted only 1,346 days. Most of us were never called upon to perform some obvious heroic act. Our service will not be memorialized with a plaque, a statue. No military base will announce our name at its entrance gate in our honor, and no one will ever stumble across our names in the title of a biography sitting on the shelf of a museum gift shop. Yet you are heroic and did remarkable things as part of our team. Today our community says thank you. Today our community says they are proud to have us among them. Today we are recognized as the trainers and the mentors of those who followed in our footsteps. Be a proud veteran. Perhaps, as Mr. Ledoux said, America did not say it in the 1960s and 70s when you came home, but she is talking to you now. The world today is a much changed place from what we witnessed in Vietnam. I was last in Vietnam in 2007 and had the privilege of having the Minister of Culture, member of the Central Committee of the Communist Party of North Vietnam, as my host. He took me around, he was my guide, and everywhere we went, he introduced me as His Excellency, the Air Pirate, because that's what they called us. Everyone laughed and thought it was a joke. No hatred, no animosity, no nasty finger gestures, just a good laugh. The back half of the Hanoi Hilton is now a 25-story office tower, and like such structures in the world, the ground floor houses a number of shops and stores. On the very site of one of my old cells there now stands a golf store. If I wasn't here today, I would be on the golf course, my current affliction, for which the VA has no medicine. So, let's enjoy the time. Slap on the back, the hoist of the glass, and say, I'm proud to know you all. And we heard the first verse of the Star Spangled Banner today. But there are four. We never get around to the fourth verse. It says, and thus be it ever when free men shall stand between their loved homes and war's desolation, blessed with victory and peace. May the seven rescued land praise the power that has made and preserved us a nation. Then conquer we must when our cause is not just, and this be our motto, in God is our trust. and the Star-Spangled Banner in triumph shall wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave. You are the brave. You've proved that. Nobody can take that away from you. So whether it's a hooah,
hoorah,
aim high, or just a simple grunt, a clank of the answer, whatever it is, a semper high. Welcome home, guys. See you at the bar. God bless you all.
Thank you, sir, for your service and sacrifice both during Vietnam and after. At this time, we'd like to present you with a token of appreciation.
Where's our charger? You got it? Okay. Give him a good side. Here we go.
This time I'd like to invite Mark Kaharski, the president of the Vietnam Veterans Memorial Park in Dayton, to come forward for a reading of a presidential proclamation. Mr. Kaharski is an Army Vietnam veteran, the president of the park, as I mentioned, and also a former employee of the Dayton VA Medical Center. Mark.
Good morning, everyone. It is indeed an honor to be here this morning amongst such a dignified collection of veterans, and I'm proud to be one of them, and to be in this hallowed and historic building, the second church built by the federal government, only eclipsed by the chapel at West Point. This entire medical center and the Dayton National Cemetery is all hallowed ground that was set aside by Abraham Lincoln to honor the veterans. Let us never forget that this was built for the veterans. It is my honor to read to you the presidential proclamation commemorating the 50th anniversary of the Vietnam War. A proclamation. As we observe the 50th anniversary of the Vietnam War, we reflect with solemn reverence upon the valor of a generation that served with honor. We pay tribute to the more than 3 million servicemen and women who left their families to serve bravely. A world away from everything they knew and everyone they loved. From Ia Drang to Khe Sanh, from Hue to Saigon, and countless villages in between, they pushed through jungles and rice paddies, heat and monsoon, fighting heroically to protect the ideals we hold dear as Americans. Through more than a decade of combat, over air, land, and sea, these proud Americans upheld the highest traditions of our armed forces. As a grateful nation, we honor more than 58,000 patriots, their names etched in black granite, who sacrificed all they had and all they would ever know. We draw inspiration from the heroes who suffered unspeakably as prisoners of war, yet who returned home with their heads held high. We pledge to keep faith with those who were wounded and still carry the scars of war, seen and unseen. With more than 1,600 of our service members still among the missing, we pledge as a nation to do everything in our power to bring these patriots home. In the reflection of the wall, we see the military family members and veterans who carry a pain that may never fade. May they find peace in knowing their loved ones endure, not only in medals and memories, but in the hearts of all Americans who are forever grateful for their service, valor, and sacrifice. In recognition of a chapter in our nation's history that must never be forgotten, let us renew our sacred commitment to those who answered our country's call in Vietnam and those who awaited their safe return. Beginning on Memorial Day 2012, the federal government will partner with local governments, private organizations, and communities across America to participate in the commemoration of the 50th anniversary of the Vietnam War. A 13-year program to honor and give thanks to a generation of proud Americans who saw our country through one of the most challenging missions we have ever faced. While no words will ever be fully worthy of their service, nor any honor truly befitting their sacrifice, let us remember that it is never too late to pay tribute to the men and women who answered the call of duty with courage and valor. Let us renew our commitment to the fullest possible accounting for those who have not returned. Throughout this commemoration, let us strive to live up to their example by showing our Vietnam veterans, their families, and all who have served the fullest respect and support of a grateful nation. Now, therefore, I, Barack Obama, President of the United States of America, by virtue of the authority vested in me by the Constitution and the laws of the United States, do hereby proclaim May 28, 2012, through November 11, 2025, as the commemoration of the 50th anniversary of the Vietnam War. I call upon federal, state, and local officials to honor our Vietnam veterans, our fallen, our wounded, those unaccounted for, and our former prisoners of war, their families, and all who served with appropriate programs, ceremonies, and activities. In witness whereof, I have hereunto set my hand this 25th day of May in the year of our Lord 2012 and of the independence of the United States of America, the 236th. That concludes the proclamation. And in conclusion, I have one statement for my fellow veterans. Welcome home.
Thank you, Mark, for doing that. And thank you for everything you do for Vietnam veterans, especially with the park. It's really great. I'm glad that you are available to do that. We're fortunate today to have Vietnam veterans, as you've seen and heard, with us as pinners for this ceremony. But they too deserve recognition for their service. So before we begin the official portion, we would like these few members to come forward to receive their own commemoration pins. At this time, we'd like to formally pin and welcome home the Vietnam veterans who are with us today. Pinners, please take your positions. As we're setting up, these pins are available to a veteran of any service who served from November of 1955 to May of 1975, regardless of location. We have several pinners this morning, as you can see, including General Meckenbauer, Mr. Kaharski. Here in the middle, we have retired Air Force Colonel Mark Butler, who also serves as our Chief of Pharmacy Service at the Dayton VA. Across, or directly behind him, we have Dan Barford, an Army Vietnam veteran, who now works at the Dayton National Cemetery. And we have Army veteran and chaplain Kenneth Boyd, who is standing in the back. Here in the yellow, we have Cindy LaPointe Daffler, representing all who lost a spouse in Vietnam and the Gold Star wives. Cindy's husband was awarded the Medal of Honor, the Silver Star, and the Purple Heart for his service in Vietnam. And representing all who lost a parent in Vietnam, Catherine Beers in the purple. She also works with the Miami Valley History Museum. Catherine's father was awarded the Distinguished Service Cross and the Purple Heart for service during the Vietnam War. For our Vietnam veterans in attendance, we'd like to welcome you to come forward to receive your pin and other commemoration materials. If you could, just please make your way to the closest pinner in front of you, receive it, and then return to your seat. If you do need assistance or would like a pinner to come to you, please raise your hand and we'll make that happen. Please come forward. Thank you. As veterans are receiving these pins, I'm going to talk a little bit about the pin and a little bit of the symbolism behind it. These pins were authorized by Congress to be presented to living United States veterans who served on active duty in the U.S. Armed Forces, as I said, from 1 November 1955 to 15 May 1975, regardless of location. Each pin has an eagle, and the eagle represents courage, honor, and dedicated service to our nation. As one of the most recognizable and notable American symbols, it is emblazoned with distinction on numerous military insignia. Each pin has a blue circle. The color matches the canton of the American flag and signifies vigilance, perseverance, and justice. The circle shape in blue color also matches the official seal of the commemoration. A laurel wreath, a time-honored symbol representing victory, integrity, and strength. The stripes on each pin represent, behind the eagle, represent the American flag. Each pin has six stars that represent the six allies who served, sacrificed, and fought alongside one another. Australia, New Zealand, the Philippines, the Republic of Korea, Thailand, and the United States. And each pin also has a message. A grateful nation thanks and honors you, is embossed on the back, closest to the heart of the wearer, along with commemoration's name. So it looks as if we're finished, but I want to make sure we give every Vietnam veteran an opportunity to receive these pens here during the ceremony. So if there's anybody we missed, please raise your hand now and we'll bring one to you. Okay, well, I'd like to thank our guest pinners, both for their service and for being a part of today's commemoration ceremony. Now, if you will please rise, and if Chaplain Tony can come forward for the benediction.
I want to give you one of the oldest benedictions ever written. It's for you, it's for our country. May God bless us and keep us and make his face shine upon us and give us his peace. May God bless the United States of America. And then one last thing that I've been waiting to do.
You may be seated. When we began planning this ceremony, we sat down as a committee and we decided that we didn't want this to be somber, but we wanted it instead to honor Vietnam veterans and all of you here. So hopefully we've done that today. But also, we would be remiss if we did not also honor the family members. If you are a husband or a wife, a son or a daughter, a father or mother, or any other family member or friend of someone who served in Vietnam, please stand up and be recognized for your own sacrifices. Thank you. I encourage everyone here to please take a moment before you reach out or before you depart to reach out and shake the hand of someone who stood today. They all deserve our thanks and admiration. Also, there will be refreshments provided directly over here at the Miami Valley Military History Museum, the Putnam Library. So if you head over there afterwards, you can take a look at some military memorabilia. There will be refreshments. And with that, thank you all for your attendance. Thank you for coming today to honor Vietnam veterans, and God bless. Thank you.
How you doing, folks? This is Rex from the Buckeyenest, and most of you know me by now. I've been running around the countryside since, year 2006 or something like that, doing videos and promoting my website, and you all know I'm a veteran myself. And I've got a young man in front of me. His name is Jason. Jason wants to say something to Vietnam veterans. Everybody knows that March 30th commemorated the 50th anniversary of the Vietnam War. So Jason?
I would like to give a big welcome home to the Vietnam veterans and a big thank you to the veterans that are, for the people that are out currently fighting for our freedom, and wish you all a safe journey home. Thank you.
Thank you for your time, Jason.
Thank you.
That's it. How you doing, folks? This is Rex at the Buckeyenest, and y'all know me by now. I've been running around the countryside, for a long time with this camera doing all kinds of things. Today I got a young man in front of me. His name is Brad. Brad wants to talk a little bit about, it's not just a piece of cloth. Brad is a current service member in the Navy. And where are you serving at, Brad?
Naval Base San Diego.
Okay. And what's your, in the Army we call it MOS, that was our job classification.
My rate, I'm a hospital corpsman.
Hospital corpsman, wow. I got to tell you a quick story, Brad. I used to work for one of those organizations up on my website called Veterans Outreach.
Yes.
And I was one of those guys that would run around to these different big stores, and I'd set up a table and I'd collect donations for that organization, Veterans Outreach. And stark reality slapped me in the face one afternoon. because I was sitting there and these three young men walked up and they put money in my jar, and I asked them, I said, "Are you guys veterans?" They didn't look a day over 15. And all three of them snapped to attention almost and said, "Yes, sir, we're Navy corpsmen." That was pretty awesome.
It was.
Yes, it was. So anyway, I told you what I'm going to do with all this video I'm doing, especially on this. It's not just a piece of cloth, and you've got something to say about that. What would you like to say about that?
Brothers of mine and myself, we joined the service to fight for the flag, and the flag represents your freedom. And the flag is the reason we're all here, free and safe in this country. And whether you agree with the subject or you don't, the flag is the reason you have an opinion. And it disgusts me that people have the audacity and just the selflessness to step on our flag that even your family members have fought for, mine have fought for, and our country's servicemen have died for. It's horrible.
I agree with you, Brad. We're coming up on over 2 million people have given their lives for this country.
That's right.
And all the conflicts and the wars ever since way back beyond the Indian Wars and the cavalry days and that kind of stuff. And I agree with you, and I'll say this one thing, as I've said it before. When people step on my flag, I can't be held responsible for what I might do.
Good morning, everybody. In beginning our celebration this morning, I'd like to suggest a little bit of a reflection on a Garth Brooks song, which I think will not only set the tone for the prayer that I'd like to offer, but also for the entire morning, our commemoration and celebration. It goes like this. You know, a dream is like a river, ever changing as it flows, and the dreamer's like a vessel that must follow where it goes, trying to learn from what's behind you, never knowing what's in store, makes each day a constant battle just to stay between the shores. And I will sail my vessel till the river runs dry. Like a bird upon the wind, these waters are my sky. I'll never reach my destination if I never try. Yes, I will sail my vessel till the river runs dry. Too many times we stand aside, let the water slip away, till what we've put off till tomorrow has now become today. So don't you stand upon the shoreline and say you're satisfied. Choose to chance the rapids and dare to dance the tides. I will sail my vessel till the river runs dry. Like a bird upon the wind, these waters are my sky, and I'll never reach my destination if I never try. Yes, I will sail my vessel till the river runs dry. There's bound to be rough waters, and I know I'll take some falls, but with the good Lord as my captain, I can make it through them all. I will sail my vessel till the river runs dry. Like a bird upon the wind, these waters are my sky, and I'll never reach my destination if I never try. Yes, I will sail my vessel till the river runs dry. Yes, I will sail my vessel till the river runs dry. God of all creation, we convene today with painful and bitter memories but with a triumph of the human spirit in our minds. We give thanks for the Vietnam veterans. We welcome them home. And we're mindful that they have chosen to chance the rapids. They have dared to dance the tides. With their courage and their commitment, their willingness, even to give and sacrifice all that has been given to them by you. So hear our prayer. Let your spirit be with us in these coming minutes and our celebration. Help us to recognize that these virtues which we celebrate and honor today are indeed revelations of your almighty presence in our human world. You live and reign as our God, today, always, and forever. Amen.
Amen.
Out on the front. You did what you did, so this very special group of young people can do what they're doing now.
How you doing, folks? This is Rex at the Buckeyenest, and I'm out here at Trotwood Madison High School today. And I'm doing some video on the Junior
ROTC
Reserve Officer Training Corps. And this is Colonel Dominic. He is the JROTC Battalion Commander. And he wants to say something to you Vietnam veterans.
On the behalf of the RAM Battalion, I would like to say thank you for your service.
Thank you, sir.
On behalf of the RAM Battalion, I want to say thank you for your service.
You did a fine job, young man.
I just want to say thank you to the vets for what you've done for your service.
Thank you, and I would like to thank every last one of you for your service to the nation.
125, I'd like to talk to those guys who plan on going back to college when they finish playing Army, especially if you're up around the Coochie area. If you're interested in going to college while here in Vietnam, you can enroll now at Coochie University. That's the Army Education Center of the 25th Infantry Division at Coochie. Classes offered include principles of accounting, data processing, introduction to business, beginning French, criminology, real estate, history of Western civilization, principles of speech, and American Negro history. All courses are worth 3 semester hours of college credit, and they're sponsored by the United States Armed Forces Institute. And enrollment of at least 10 students is a must for a class to be scheduled, so why don't you check it out? Don't you be a dropout. Drop in to Coochie U or give them a call in Coochie at 5143 for more details. That's Coochie University.
How you doing, folks? This is Rex at the Buckeyenest again, and we're out here at Vapor Trails doing some more video for Welcome Home to Vietnam Veterans, and I've got Michelle and Kat here, that's got something special to say to Vietnam veterans.
Welcome home.
Welcome home.
Thank you, ladies.
This is the American Forces Vietnam Network.
Audio 85 and 99.9 FM. This is AFDN tonight.
The tragedy of a traffic accident can last for a lifetime. Or worst of all, it can snuff out life. If you're the driver of the vehicle in Vietnam, it's your responsibility to see that a tragedy doesn't happen. So drive carefully and stay alert.
Correct time on the new Audio 85 at the automatic cycling cone will be precisely 1600. News time from ASVN, News Central in Saigon. This is the American Forces Vietnam Network.
How you doing, folks? This is Rex from the Buckeyenest. We've got another young man here. His name is Derek. He wants to say something special to veterans, and I think maybe even Vietnam veterans in particular.
Welcome home, veterans, and thanks for your service for us.
Thank you, Derek. You have a good day.
You too.
That's the brand. It don't matter to me. 17 minutes now after 6 o'clock with Army Specialist Jump and Jim Huntley. We're on the Vietnam Night Beat Show for the Friday evening edition all the way till 8 o'clock. You know, there's a program designed just for you to make your dreams a reality. It's the GI Bill. Ask your administration officer about the benefits awaiting you today. Let the GI Bill do you a favor. You deserve it.
ASVN.
Here comes Santana.
How you doing, folks? This is Rex from the Buckeyenest, and we're out here in Ohio, the big city of Englewood, at the Dairy Queen. And y'all know what I've been doing for the last few years. I run around the countryside doing videos and neat things like that, fixing people's computers and stuff, and I'm down here today doing version 3 of the Welcome Home and Thank You for Your Service video, which a lot of you have already seen. And I've got Matt and Beth here in front of me, and they want to say something along with Matt. Is that Matt Jr.?
This is Max.
Max. How you doing, Max? And your name was? Did he say Aiden?
Aiden, yeah.
Aiden. So they want to say something. First off, let me say this. All you old soldiers out there, these two young men here are what we do, the reasons we do what we did. So you guys take a good look at him and then you'll understand. Look at Max there. He's liking that video already. So take it away, folks.
We just wanted to say thank you for everything you have done. For our country, and we greatly appreciate it, and welcome back.
Thank you.
Welcome back.
Are you a veteran yourself, sir?
I'm not, no.
Let me tell you both something that you may not think about all the time. You are veterans. Mm-hmm. You're part of the team. Because if you don't do what you do, we can't do what we do, right?
Well, we greatly appreciate it.
Want to say goodbye, Max?
Bye-bye.
When you go on R&R, what do you want to get out of it? Do you want to go for just a good time, or would you rather mix your pleasure with some of the best shopping in the world, some of the finest culture in the East, and exhibitions of some of the greatest industrial advancements made in the last 20 years? In Japan, all of these things are at your disposal. The greatest buys in electronic equipment can be found in Tokyo, along with some of the finest modern art and architecture. While you're at it, take in a geisha house and exercise your mental prowess. Serious-minded men go to Tokyo.
Standing on the corner, singing some old song he'd wrote. You could feel his pain, he tried hard to sing each note. He wore the face of the homeless beneath a worn-out veteran's cap. He left home so full of life, but this kid never came back. He's a shell of a man, no one needs him now. He can't hold a job, and who cares anyhow? He was barely 19, no more than just a kid. Though no bullet found its mark, he's more wounded than if it did. He was halfway through college, now his dreams are long gone. Hurts to hear him say, God, when can I go home? The beds, they calm him down as his eyes stare straight ahead. It was then I began to cry as I've lived every word he said. He's a shell of a man, and no one needs him now. He can't hold a job, and who cares? Barely 19, no more than just a kid. Though no bullet found its mark, he's more wounded than if it did. I heard someone whisper, anyone know his name? They say he went to war, but he never came back the same. Then I heard someone say, why does he live this way? Lord, they don't understand, these torments never go away. He's a shell of a man, and no one needs him now. He can't hold a job, and who cares anyhow? He was barely 19, no more than just a kid. Though no bullet found its mark, he's more wounded than if it did. The meds, they calm him down as his eyes stare straight ahead.
How you doing, folks? It's Rex from the Buckeye Nest, and you all know me by now. I've been running around the countryside for the last several years doing different things, and I'm out here today at the Dairy Queen in Englewood, Ohio on Main Street. And I'm enhancing that welcome home video that I did for the March 30th event for the commemoration of the Vietnam War. Got a couple of people here in front of me that may want to wait just a minute until the motorcycle can go by. There we go. That want to say something to veterans.
Hi, this is Rick and Cindy Scoville from Englewood, Ohio, and just want to thank all the Vietnam veterans out there for your years of service. I wasn't able. I was too late for the Vietnam War, but certainly appreciate everything that you guys did for our country and what you continue to do for our country. God bless you all.
Thank you, sir.